good evening. So may I have your attention, please, guys? We are starting. So we are. This is second session in the second day of the Executive Council Soapbox. Right now, we'll begin the. We'll begin the Institute Sports Secretary Soapbox. In a while, we have three candidates: Rohan Lal, Shrinath Bhat, and Keerthana. We'll go in that order. We'll begin with Rohan.
Hello, friend. I am Rohan Lal. I am contesting for the post of Institute Sports Secretary. Hello, 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 friends. I am Rohan Lal, contesting for the post of Institute Sports Secretary.
Speak a bit louder.
Hello, 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 friends. I am Rohan Lal, contesting for the post of Institute Sports Secretary. As far as sports is concerned in our institute, the scenario is quite good, but there are few fields which we can improve. So here are new initiatives which I have. First of all, introduction of new games like kabaddi, kho kho. And kick volleyball. As we know, there are various hostels which have pool table facilities, and there are enough number of players which play pool tables, but our institute do not conduct any competition for pool table. So here I would like to add this pool table in our inter-hostel competition. Now, next is the introduction of horse riding club. This could be done with the help of Madras School of Equitation, which we could have a sort of collaboration with them and provide a horse riding for the interested learners. For skaters, normally they practice in Sangam ground, and normally Sangam ground is having both football and skating. So there could a condition where accident may happen because it is quite busy. So here I would like to provide a rust-free environment where only skaters could practice. Now coming to booking of slots, so here I would like to provide both online and offline booking of sports courts and sports fields. For new learners who want to improve their games and who want to be consistent, so I would like to introduce a training sessions which would be for all, for UG, PG. And for girls. For improvement of hostel sports, there would be a regular meeting with hostel sports secretaries, and various aspects would be discussed so to improve the hostel sports. Also, there will be a committee which would be responsible for selection of various institute teams, and there would be a feedback mechanism which would help to improve the conducted events. Now coming to infrastructure modification, as a gym, there are old equipments and which would be replaced by the new and the modified ones. In our institute, there are more badminton players, and the sack is always occupied by the badminton players, and most of the time it is the players have to wait for their chance. So there is a need of more badminton wooden courts, so new badminton courts would be installed. Also in our institute, there is no wooden basketball court, so installation of new wooden basketball court would be there. Now coming to cricket camp plus ground, there is no facility of playing night matches. Also there is no facility of ropes for recognition of boundary. We have an analog display of scores. So here I would like to introduce a digital display and ropes for recognition of the boundary, and lights to have a facility which would provide to playing in night. Now coming to hockey and football ground, the quality of grass is not good there, so improving the quality of the grass, and also the hockey outskirt is not bounded by the boundaries. Most of the time ball is lost in the jungle, so their boundaries will be constructed, fencing would be done, and also there is no washroom near hockey and football ground, so that would be installed there. Coming to Manohar C. Vasta Stadium, there is no lighting facilities there, so lighting facilities would be provided and timing would be revised. That's it. Thank you.
So that was Rohan Lal. Up next, we have Shrinath Bhat.
Hello everyone, I am Shrinath Bhat. I am a third year undergraduate student contesting for the post of Institute Sports Secretary. And can you go to the next one? My vision is to bring in a conducive and inviting environment for everyone. I want to ensure inclusivity, accessibility and transparency. And for doing so, I'll be introducing a gymming cum fitness club. Next. This is for professional gymming and calisthenics. Just like all other clubs, this will have club weekenders and beginner sessions. I'll be bringing in women's powerlifting and para powerlifting competitions. Just as 53rd Intriti had powerlifting, para powerlifting, I'll be bringing in this IIT Madras too, so that we can encourage the athletes have this competition and perform better. I'll be having an exclusive football camp for women in cricket and football. A lot of people don't get in NSO program just because the number of people getting in is really less. The cap is really less. That's why I'll be bringing in an split-wise NSO program. There will be two batches of NSO from now. A certified program for PGs will be introduced. Now there will be a channel for these PG students to practice along with NSO UGs. An institute-wide madras race will be launched. This is a combination of CrossFit Murph and an obstacle course race. There will be hurdles, we need to jump over them, crawl underneath. There will be certain number of push-ups, squats, etc., etc. For streamlining whatever processes are there in the institute, I'll be bringing in a grievance management portal. This will be in the IIT Madras sports website. And if you have any grievances or any suggestions you want to make, you can let me know through this. There will be sports days of the week, and every Tuesday and Friday will now on be called as sports days of the week. And I'm bringing this so that all the sporting activities, all the beginners camp happen only on these 2 days. This is for spreading the awareness. I'll be having digital certificates from now on. All the sporting events will be given digital certificates from now on. A lending system for non-marking shoes will be brought in. So now, even if students don't have this non-marking shoes, they can lend it by giving their ID card, and after their practice gets over, they can return it back to them. For recognizing talent and for felicitating students who do hard work, I'll be bringing in Institute Orange Tag. Fitness sessions in Saturday mornings will be there, and for incentivizing these people, I'll be bringing in morning hour refreshment. This year, a lot of students had lost on games in Schroiter and in Intriti just because they couldn't handle the game pressure, not because we lacked on any talent. That's why a proposal to have an introduction of elective course for handling game pressure will be there. Nutrition charts and a workshop by dietitian will be introduced to know, let them know how to become fit and what and all we should be eating, what and all we shouldn't be eating, etc., etc. Few of the infrastructure changes which I'll be bringing in includes a proposal to construct a multi-story building with a new gym, a new table tennis court, and a synthetic badminton court. And why am I bringing this? All of you know, if you see people are playing badminton, they are not, few people aren't getting opportunity to play over there. That's why I'll be bringing a proposal to construct a new synthetic badminton court, and same applies for table tennis court and a new gym. Lot of people want to do beast training for strength and endurance, and that's why I'll be bringing in a sand track in Manohar Srivastava Stadium. Tower hostels don't have the infrastructure to practice cricket. Hence, I'll be bringing in a portable cricket net in Manohar Srivastava Stadium. Lot of people might be tired after practice and hungry before practice, right? That's why I'll be installing vending machines in SAC and Gymkhana. So whenever you are hungry, you can grab something to eat, or whenever you're thirsty, you can grab something to drink. I'll be having a discount system for all the sporting outlets which are there near the institute. So if you show your ID card, you can get things for discount from now. I'll be launching an exclusive YouTube channel. All the sporting activities will be put up over here. And we'll be having captains speak about their inter-IT experiences, and the sports secretary speaking about their Schroiter experiences, etc., etc. I'll be introducing a web ops team in sports organizing committee, and they'll be taking care of all the maintenance and all the new things which I'll be bringing in the sports website. We'll be having an alumni donation portal, and a sports alumni database will be created. We'll be pitching these people for donating for the sporting sphere. There will be an exclusive t-shirt sale, because a lot of people don't know that there are sporting clubs in the institute. And for branding these clubs, I'll be having an exclusive t-shirt sale. We'll be collaborating with an American company named USAI. So basically, these people will be commercializing all the sports. They'll be live telecasting all the matches which they're organizing. And now we'll be able to be part of an organization who will be giving us merchandises for free, and just like IPL, we'll be now having a separate logo for ourselves, a separate name for ourselves. I'll just brief down my credentials. I am hostel sports secretary for Godavari Hostel. Finance core for sports organizing committee. Institute Athletics Convener, I was also given the name of Mr. NSO as I got selected in most number of NSOs. So yeah, from my credentials, you can come to know that from my freshman year, I was in the sporting sphere and I've been working hard towards it. And I had made a great impact in the hostel which I was in, being a sports secretary. Now I want to scale it up to the institute level. And for doing so, I require your support. So do vote for me. So once again, I am Shrinath Bhat. Do vote for me if you like to manifest. Thank you.
So guys, I warn you, if the crowd gets out of control, we'll just stop the soapbox and not have it at all. Okay. That will be the last thing. Before that, we'll see a line of people walking out of this venue. So next up is Keerthana with her presentation.
Hi everyone, I'm Keerthana. I'm one of the aspiring candidates for Institute Sports Secretary. My vision for sports in the Institute is to celebrate sporting history. Can you increase this volume? My vision for sports in Institute is to celebrate our sporting history and promote sport as an experience for all. It is also to develop a more inclusive sporting community by including more diverse sets of people and facilitating their growth. I plan on including a diverse set of people in sports through the following initiatives. Hostel-wise beginner camps are a great way for people to learn a sport, find similar players in their hostel and play regularly and also have fun while doing so. PG Initiation Week will be conducted at the beginning of every semester, and during this week, all institutes, courts and facilities will be thrown open exclusively for PG students so that they can feel more at home. A para sports representative can act as a voice for para athletes and spearhead initiatives to include more people with disabilities. An NSO sport change mechanism will give freshies that much needed flexibility to change their NSO sport at the beginning of their odd semester. For this, you will have to have certain eligibility criteria like prior selection in both sports, 100% attendance in the previous sport, coach's consent of both sports. Also, only a 10% flux will be allowed from each sport. NSO football and cricket programs will be introduced to girls to cater to the growing freshy female community as well as their desire to play these sports. A sports calendar will be published at the beginning of every semester and will be integrated with IITM Students App and IITM Sports website so that everyone knows all the club initiatives and all inter-IT teams activities. We need to create channels to facilitate and nurture our sports talent. Active player groups can act as communities for every sport. So these communities will consist of institute team players and institute team probables, yes, but they'll also have NSO players for that sport, hostel team members of that sport, and PG initiated people. Flagship events will be conducted for each club to increase the club's publicity. So these events will be like club weekenders and auction-based leagues, which will be restricted to the active player groups. Visual footage of important matches and important practice drills can be taken to improve team strategy and individual skill sets. So fitness scorecards for institute team members will be maintained throughout the semester to track the performance and improvement of fitness of these players. So introduction of chess and Schreuter in the classical format will be a great platform to hone talent for the inter-IIT chess meet. The institute main gym currently is open to women between 3:30 to 5:30 p.m. It is mostly an inaccessible time for many female students. So I propose to open the women's gym in Sabarmati to all women and have a female gym instructor appointed there. We must celebrate our sporting history and recognize the achievements of our student athletes. Only then will more people be inspired to take up sports. Inter-IIT match highlights will be compiled and uploaded on social media, so they can give a lot more insights than just results cards or score sheets. Tales of inter-IIT are usually restricted only to the sports contingent. So they can be told to the entire student community by publishing articles with the help of Fifth Estate and Chennai 36 through the SOC PR team. Media coverage of Schreuter and other competitive events will give these tournaments much needed publicity.
Can you increase the volume?
A wall of fame in SAC will commemorate our sporting heritage and give a platform for us to showcase our inter-IIT silverware. Legacy exhibits at particular sports can showcase the team's mottos, logos and medal tallies. The Institute Book of Records will document the records of not only inter-IIT, Sports Fest, Schreuter and Dean's Trophy, but also fitness achievements like who can do the most amount of push-ups consecutively, or the most number of burpees in a minute, or the longest elbow plank. So these can be recorded in the Institute Book of Records as well. Digitized record keeping of inter-IIT scorecards, Sports Fest, Schreuter, Dean's Trophy, ladder systems of our racket sports will make sure that we document our sporting culture. Sports brings people together, and we need to make it as an experience for everyone. Institute sports merchandise like t-shirts, keychains, bottles and caps will make sure that we brand sports better and generate revenue for SOC. A traditional sports league can be conducted with sabhas and samitis to encourage participation and revive traditional games. A non-competitive sports league for snooker and foosball can be seen as an avenue for recreation and developing team spirit. Mass screenings of cricket, football, tennis, and other sports will be made more regularly. In order to achieve what all of the initiatives that I have listed down in my manifesto, I have a special strategy that involves restructuring SOC and redefining the club's responsibilities, so that even if I'm elected as the Institute Sports Secretary, and even after my tenure is done, these initiatives stay within the sports system. So the current structure for SOC includes three representatives and four teams. The PG representative, women's representative and para sports representative. The four teams are sponsorship and PR, events and operation, media and design and finance. So the additional responsibilities to these teams are explained in detail in my feasibility report. The club responsibilities will mainly be to inspire people to take up that sport and to conduct competitive and non-competitive events for that sport. So a clear demarcation of responsibilities of the club convener and the captain at the beginning of the tenure itself will give captains a certain sense of autonomy and freedom to take decisions. So their value to the sports culture will also increase.
Right.
Sports has been a major part of my life here in the Institute. I've been a part of the inter-IIT contingent from my fresh year in the tennis team. Our team has won our team has won 1 gold and 2 silver medals. I've captained our team twice. I've been the Sharaf sports secretary once, and I've also been a part of the public relations team in SOC. Right. And I've also been a part of the public relations team in the sports organizing committee. I think that I'm well equipped now to give back to a community that has shaped my life so much in the institute. And I feel I can shape the sporting culture and create tangible impact. So once again, guys, this is Keerthana, contesting for the post of Institute Sports Secretary. Thank you.
So, with that, all the three candidate presentations are over. Now, we'll move on to cross-questioning. We'll have to look at time. So, within 20 minutes, we'll finish everything. You can ask 3 questions each to each other and have 2 follow-ups on them. Make sure that you answer very concise and, you know, quickly. We'll begin in the order of presentation. So, we'll go question by 3 rounds. We'll go in 3 rounds. So Rohan can ask first question to Shrinath.
Hello, Shrinath. I would like to know your views regarding pool table and its introduction in inter-hostel competitions. What do you think about that? Pool table, introduction of pool table in inter-hostel competitions.
Can you repeat your question?
I want to know Shrinath's views regarding pool table competitions and its introduction in inter-hostel competitions.
So bro, if you know that last year Kishore also wanted to propose this, but not all the hostels have pool table. That's why introducing this in Dean's Trophy right now is not possible. But if every hostel gets a pool table, definitely we can include this.
So Keerthana, in the ground level, if we see that, for example, we take a cricket camp plus ground, you have not shared your views regarding regarding any ropes or digital display. There is only analog display, and also for night matches, there is no facility for night matches. So can you share your views? What are your views regarding that?
Firstly, the authority to use ChemPlus doesn't solely lie with solely lie with our campus. We share it with Sanmarg.
As in cricket campus ground, there are no facilities for rope for boundary recognition, and also boundary recognition, and no digital display. There are analog ones, and also there is no facility for night matches. Also, there is no light. We have in football ground, but in cricket ground, we don't have. So, what are your views, and what will you do for regarding that?
The Kemplas cricket ground is not managed by IIT Madras alone. We manage it along with Sanmat. So any infrastructure improvements will be taken up in collaboration with them, like after consulting them. So that's how it will be.
Bro, for installation of floodlights in Manohar Srivastava Stadium, whom did you ask? Whom did you consult?
Actually, I consulted with many of hostel sports secretaries. They told that most of the students are free in night hours. And they want to practice in nights, and we have strict conditions that at 7:30 or 8 p.m. the Manohar Srivastava Stadium is closed. So I think extending the time would work, and that could be happen only if we have lights installed in it.
So we, everyone knows that there is this problem. We require these courts and Manohar Srivastava Stadium to be open till late night. But the permission which requires to be taken needs to be passed through director. And you haven't talked to anyone. You have talked to hostel sports secretaries. So first, get to know whom you should be approaching for all this.
Thank you for your suggestion. I will do that.
So my next question goes to Keerthana. So there is women's gym already in Sabarmati, and Dost and sports advisor have already told that they won't be giving a female instructor. So what is your plan? We can't allow females of other hostels to enter through main gate, and neither can we let them enter from the back gate. So what is your plan? Can you tell me in brief?
Let me first establish the need for an exclusive women's gym here, okay?
So the Keerthana, stick to the answer. Stick to the answer, you've already done that.
All right.
Let me repeat the question. There is women's gym already in Sabarmati.
The women's gym in Sabarmati is also very well equipped. And right now, the dean of students and gym and the sports advisor do not want to fund a female gym instructor there because it is in the hostel zone. And maintenance of these gyms should come under the sports budget of the hostel secretaries. But if you look at the cost to employ a female gym instructor, considering a basic pay of 16,000 per month, it takes a load of 48,000 rupees per year per hostel. Per hostel. If you want, the sports budgets of girls' hostels are of the order of 60,000 to of the age range 60,000 to 80,000. Let's consider a bigger cap. Let's consider 1 lakh rupees also. So you're looking at around 50% of our sports budget dedicated only to employing a female gym instructor. We are also paying the institute gymkhana fees, which is 1,000 rupees per semester per student. So we feel that we also need to have accessible gym facilities. So once I brought this up to dean, students and sports advisor, they have reconsidered. They have reconsidered their claim to expect hostel secretaries to pay for it, and they're willing to employ a female gym instructor out of Gymkhana's budget.
Uh, Yeah, let me brief it down. So, Sabarmati students are not willing to pay the 48,000 which you are telling about it.
Exactly why it needs to be a part of the Gymkhana budget. Thank you.
I already clearly mentioned that those and sports advisor both have said no to it.
Exactly. So, very true, Shrinath, you've got that right. So when I spoke to the Dean of Students and Sports Advisor, they split the budget to me like this, okay? They split the budget that is required to employ a female gym instructor, costing about 10 rupees per student per hostel per year. So they're like, 10 rupees is not a great amount for a person to make, right? But if you look at our sports budget itself, our budget amounts to 20 rupees per month. So out of that, 10 rupees is going to a female gym instructor. I am explaining to you again, okay? So 16,000 rupees per month gym instructor fees, no, if you split it among all four hostels equally, each hostel needs to pay 48,000 rupees per year, okay? Our sports budget is 80,000. Consider 1 lakh. Even if it is 1 lakh, it is 50% of it is going to go to the gym instructor, which is a huge amount. So after I heard a no, I heard a reject, they rejected my proposal when I first went to them. But when I told them the plight of our sports budget in girls' hostels, they have reconsidered it. Right now, the Gymkhana will pay for it.
Okay, so firstly, you should have asked the finance core about whatever feasibility you were thinking of. Don't you think that other secretaries weren't aware of this?
You should have asked the finance core what the feasibility of it is. With that, your second follow-up stops.
So, the finance core of the SOC is responsible to finance the budgets that we get from Gymkhana. If the dean students and if the sports advisor are willing to pay for a gym instructor, I don't think I need any other positions for responsible.
See, that question is done. Move on to the next question. Now Keerthana's chance to ask Rohan first. See,
check.
Shrinath, my question to you.
Rohan.
Sorry, oh, Rohan. You mentioned in your manifesto that you're going to improve the grass on football and hockey grounds. So how do you plan on doing it? Do you have a semester-wise or a year-wise plan to do so?
I would like to answer that. If you see cricket campus ground, there are much more improved grass and there is regular interval of water sprinkles there. So there we can have a similar situations, and this would surely work for improvement of grass in hockey and football ground.
My next question to you, Shrinath. Please bear with me. It's a long one. So this is with regard to your proposal to construct a multi-story building with gym, table tennis courts, and synthetic badminton courts. Okay. So Shrinath, I'd like you to clarify 2 points for me. Okay. First point is with regard to the location of this building. Okay. You said that the construction of this building will be near the swimming pool. After having spoken to the dean planning, this area is in the deer corridor. No construction is allowed in this area, even in the parking lot. Okay. MHRD has mandated that there is a cap on the area of under construction on campus. That cap right now stands at 25%. and we have saturated it. Okay, so any sort of further construction will require demolishing of existing infrastructure. What infrastructure are you going to demolish? The second point that I would like you to clarify to me is with regard to the timeline. So you said you're going to propose for this building, right? When will this proposal be approved? So the dean planning
Location.
No, it's the same question. 2 points in the same question. So see, the dean planning
Keerthana,
and those.
Keerthana.
I mentioned at the beginning. Wait, can you ask it as follow up? Not now. I mentioned at the beginning that it's 2 points.
I'll take it as one follow up.
So dean planning and those said that unless Mandak is demolished and reconstructed, unless the SFC is constructed in boys hostel area, unless the Guru and unless the Gopal Krishnan Deshpande Center for C5 is established, and unless the new academic complex construction part 2 is done, no infrastructure proposals will be entertained. So when do you plan on introducing this proposal and getting it approved?
So first clarification, that was one question and one follow-up.
Let me answer to the question first. So maybe you got the location wrong. So my proposal was to construct a building inside the compound which comes in the footprint. So there is no deer habitat over there. And regarding the timeline, this will be coming up after the indoor court which Kishore had proposed. This will be coming up after the construction of indoor court which Kishore had proposed. That and all, dean planning will be taking care.
Approximate time in your tenure. Will it come in your tenure later?
Proposal will be made by me, and being a secretary, my job is to make the proposal, and dean planning, those will be taking care of all the remaining things.
I think I've read your feasibility report right when you mentioned that this building will come up near the swimming pool. All right, I will take your explanation saying that it will be constructed within the swimming pool grounds. But I would like you to answer me this. Okay, so the funds for constructing whatever Kishore has proposed or whatever you have proposed, where do you plan on acquiring these funds?
Institute will be funding this. Just like how Gymkhana was constructed, we did not pay. The institute had paid. That's where we'll get.
Any more clarification on the source? Any more clarification on the source other than just institute will be funding?
Institute will be funding it. I did not get you.
Any more clarity? Just institute will be funding.
Yeah.
Rohan, second.
Hello. My second question to Shrinath. As new games
no,
like
one
Kabaddi,
minute, Rohan.
These.
Rohan, 1 minute.
So, Shrinath, as you know, Kabaddi is now a trending game in India and it is expanding. So, what are your views to bringing it in our campus? How do you think that? How can we do? Or do you?
Kabaddi is not allowed in the institute as it's a contact sport.
We can have as a contact game. Why do you think that we can't have that contact game?
It's not allowed in the institute. We can't have it. Even if we want to have it, we can't have it.
Okay.
So let me get clear. Kabaddi can't be happening in the institute as it's a contact sport.
Badminton here in SAC. So what do you think means, could we have a installation of more badminton wooden courts and that would be sufficient, and what are your views regarding that?
So the question was that the badminton courts in SAC are almost always congested, whether I had any plans on improving the infrastructure facilities to accommodate more people. So my answer to this, Rohan, would be this, okay. In order to increase accessibility of sports in the student community, we need not always resort to increasing infrastructure and increasing the number of courts, because at the end of the day, resources are always going to be limited. Instead, we can plan on better on using these resources. A couple of my manifesto points address this issue. One of these manifesto points that I have that addresses this issue is sports calendar. So sports calendar will give you the NSO days, the NSO timings, the institute team primings, any tournaments that will be conducted, so that you have a plan. You know when to come to the courts and when you don't have to come to the courts. I mean, when the courts are full. My second initiative that addresses this is active player groups. So take badminton for example. The institute badminton team is a small set of people. There is a slightly larger set of people that consists of the institute team and the institute team probables, those that want to make it into the institute team. And right now, the only other recognized body is the badminton club, which I think that we need a better set of people that we can include, a more targeted inclusive group of sorts. So my active player groups and the events that I conduct for these active player groups will address this matter as well.
My exact question was regarding the rush in the badminton court. I think this is not related to any NSO or thing. The main issue is that people want to play badminton and in their free time. So I think here there is a need of badminton court because there is always a rush. You can see, and if you went to hostels also, the badminton courts are occupied of the hostels also.
My answer will remain the same. Resources are always limited. Even if we construct 10 badminton courts, we still cannot accommodate all 9,000 people and accommodate it at a time of their convenience. So I believe that in addition to improving infrastructure facilities, we should also focus on using them better.
Bro, this is not a question, but I really want to have horse riding in the institute. Please bring it as soon as possible.
For that, I would like to answer that there is one Madras School of Equitation, which is located in Vellacherry. We could have a sort of collaboration with them, and there they have all the facilities there. And if you could not have horses here in our institute, we can go there. This it is nearby, so that would work.
Okay, Rohan, so for feasibility, whom did you ask? Whom did you consult?
Actually, I did not consult anyone.
Okay, Keerthana, so my second question is for you, and I want to know, I talked to sports advisor, and he said that if you want to increase, and if you want to have NSO cricket and football for women, then we will have to have a trade-off between boys and girls cap. So the total number will be fixed. If you have girls NSO over there, then the number of boys getting in NSO will be reduced. So what do you say regarding that?
Let me go back to the root cause of why I want to increase NSO seats for girls in football and cricket. Because of the supernumerary quota, the increase in the girl student intake is more. So we have a 14% quota for girls. Just by that logic, there needs to be a proportionate rise in the amount of girls, amount of seats for NSO in girls. I am not sure why Dean has why the sports advisor I'm sorry has told you that would need a trade-off of the number of seats in boys. But when I spoke about this to the Dean of Students as well as the sports advisor, they didn't seem to have a problem with it. When I brought this up to the PTIs of the concerned sports, they didn't seem to have a problem with it.
So Keerthana, so basically you want to say that you'll be cutting down on number of boys and having this NSO for women makes sense, but don't you think having an exclusive camp for women for football and cricket would be a better option?
I will split this question into two parts. First, I will address the part where you said that the NSO seats for boys will be cut down. This is something that we don't agree upon, Shrinath, because the information that was told to me by the sports advisor and Dean of Students doesn't seem to be matching with the information that he told to you. Right, so we have a disagreement there. The second thing regarding beginner camps for football and cricket, there is currently a football in... Sorry.
So, see, when I spoke with advisor, he said they won't be increasing the cap. It'll be the same. You can't increase the cap. The number of seats will be the same. Okay? Yeah.
To address the part about beginner's camp that is there for football and cricket, there is already a football interest group with more than 50 participants, more than 50 female participants, 56 to be accurate. So when these are already happening, I don't see what like what new can be done with a beginner's camp for
the question is, given the cap, the only thing that you can do is to include girls there, which means that the opportunity for boys will reduce.
Okay.
Your comments on that?
All right. So, even if there is a cap, in fact, Kishore has earlier told me that there are several NSO seats vacant among other sports in girls. So I believe that we need to cater NSO programs to the demand of the girl students. If girl students want to play football and cricket, we need to cater to it. There is really no point in having NSO programs in sports that girls don't want to play.
Keerthana, I totally understand your concern. So better have what I have in my manifesto, have a batch-wise system for NSO, plus have this camp. So whoever is... Okay, let me repeat again. So basically, you will be reducing... So basically, you will be reducing the number of boys. And... said that the total number of people getting selected for football NSO
and I have given you my clarification that we will introduce football and cricket NSOs by compensating for the NSO of girls in other sports. In sports the girls don't want to play.
We are talking about the total cap. Boys plus girls number will be constant. It can't exceed 30 for football. That was the main point.
See, this question has taken enough time. Let's move on to Keerthana's question.
Rohan, you seem to be very concerned about the badminton facilities here. And you propose to have a wooden badminton courts constructed. My question to you is, have you budgeted for it? How much would it cost? And who have you taken permission from to get this approved?
I have ideas. Many hostels have badminton court and they are not constructed properly. So we could have a wooden and a proper construction there. And that would work properly because constructing new courts outside would be difficult. So constructing it in hostels would work.
I will repeat my question. You address the question about where you're going to construct it. But how about the budget and the permissions that you've taken to do the same?
You leave or the Soapbox ends here. Okay. much only when I say. So, Shrinath.
Hello. Sir, it's start. Regarding the permission, I would like to say that there is one problem that the main issue is that there are more number of badminton players. So I have put a solution and I have not asked anyone. The solution is that we can have more number of courts.
But because of the demand of like badminton courts, he's planning on constructing them. Shrinath, I must say. Shrinath, I must say one of the some of your manifesto points are really good, as splitting NSO into two batches and introducing a new program for PGs definitely addresses the issue of accessibility and inclusion. Right now, so there currently is a maximum of 3 sessions a week for
further action? What further action?
Hello, your attention please. Hello, can you all sit? Can you all sit quietly? Please sit down. We are here for the soapbox, right? So you should allow the candidates to cross question and other candidates to answer. If you do not allow, this cannot run. You have to cooperate. Right?
So
shall we continue or not? Okay. Please maintain silence, maintain the decorum.
So Shrinath, I was talking about these manifesto points of yours where you split NSO into two batches and introduce a new program for PGs, okay? So there is currently a maximum of 3 sessions per NSO classes per week, right? And since this information is absent from your feasibility report, I'm assuming that by introducing new batches, you now need 9 sessions per week. Could you clarify how do you plan on splitting these 9 sessions between the 7 days of the week, factoring important days like coach holidays, institute team practice, and other interested players wanting to use the court? Do you understand the question?
So if you have not got the split properly, I'll explain you in detail. So there will be batch A, which will be on
Shrinath, Monday. Hold your mic closed.
I'll explain you through an example. For odd semester, we need to have 2 sessions for NSO, right? So batch A, let's say, will have NSO on Monday. Then batch B will have on Wednesday. Then both batch A and batch B will have a combined session. And therefore, both the batches will be having 2 sessions in odd semester. And in even semester, there will be 2 sessions for batch A, 2 sessions for batch B, and a combined session for batch A and batch B together.
You've addressed the splitting of... Stop now. Let them continue. All right. You've addressed splitting of NSO, but how about the program for PGs? Second thing, when you have combined classes, will the same institute coach handle the 2 batches at the same time, or are you planning on employing new coaches?
So currently there is 1 NSO coach, and there can be only 1 NSO coach, okay, if you don't know that. Okay, fine. Now, let me tell you, PGs will also have a channel to practice along with NSO UGs. That's what
Shrinath,
I had mentioned
in closer.
That's what I had mentioned when I was presenting it to you. That basically means, in batch A and batch B, there will be a cap for PGs too.
All right, so my second follow-up will be this. So in NSO batches, let's take football, for example. The NSO batch football right now has 28, 29 students. Let's take 30. So batch A will have 30, batch B will have 30. Considering that you have a PG criteria within that 30, you are looking at
training 60 people at once during these combined sessions. How effective do you think these camps will be when one coach is handling 60 people?
Have you mentioned anywhere that the cap will be double? Have you mentioned anywhere that the cap will be double? Now, football currently has 30, right? So now, the captain and the coach will be deciding on the numbers. So now, let's say 25 and 25 are there. Okay? And when these combined sessions are there, that time intra-IIT practice won't be there. And I have made the timeline in such a way that it won't clash with the institute practice.
Can you stop now? Can you stop now? Thank you. Do you want another round of one? They have, I think, all one more question left. I'm asking, do you want one more round of that, or should we move on to Executive Council and GSB questioning because we are a bit short on time? Agreement is on one more round by the candidates. Cool. First is Rohan.
So as you know, skaters practice in Sangam ground, but simultaneously football players also play there and skaters also. So don't you think there could be an accident because
Rohan,
the outskirt road, of the road can. So, do you think there could be an improvement regarding that skaters and where skaters practice in Sangam ground?
See, Rohan. Okay, so he wanted to know whether there can be any infrastructure change which can improve the skating culture or the Sangam where they practice skating. Can that be improved some way? That's what his question was.
Simultaneously, football means players also play football and simultaneously skaters also practice there. So there could be collision type of thing with them.
See, Rohan, there is always constraint for infrastructure. And we all know that for any construction, if there is no valid reason, we can't have the infrastructure changes happening over there. We will be slotting timings for skating and football in such a way that it won't clash with each other, and there will be skating practice. After that, this football practice will be going on, or before that, it will be going on. It won't happen simultaneously because it has safety issues.
Okay. So, Keerthana, what do you think about online and offline booking slots of various sports courts and fields? What do you think the online and offline both ways of booking slots for courts like badminton court in SAC?
I think it's a great initiative if you're able to book slots online, and if you can come up with a team and a mechanism to do so, I think it's a great initiative. Is that what you're trying to ask me? I'm not really...
I'm trying to ask that how would you implement that? Means there are classes, for example, football and skaters, there is a clash and there could have an accident or problem. So how would you manage that? So there are no, means simultaneously, no two events can occur like that. Means booking of slots, for example, if you want to have
online booking of slots,
online and offline both ways. So,
what is the question?
For every sports, for example, if you go to cricket camp,
what exactly is it? What exactly is the question?
So
what
I'm
is her
asking
plans
what
for online and offline booking of slots?
Both. So what is she doing right now?
I'll repeat.
What are your plans for that?
Yeah.
You clear?
The question was, can you hear me? The question was, what is Keerthana's plan for online and offline booking of slots for various sports and institute?
Let me pair this into Gymkhana facilities, SAC. In Gymkhana facilities, we have the volleyball courts, basketball courts, tennis courts, football ground, Kempla stand, the hockey ground, and the SAG badminton courts here. So right now there is no booking system of sorts for any sporting facility except Sangam. Kempla is being used to conduct other tournaments apart from the inter-hostel tournaments and institute team practice. So we don't have complete control over there. So that is pretty established. But to book other sports right now, a schedule is drawn and it is consulted with the institute captain and we work around it.
Stop. Someone that side is creating disturbance here. I want that person off the stage, okay? While she is talking, they're creating disturbance. No. Okay, this is not like the other cases. Other cases, okay, you are cheering at least, but this is very clearly creating disturbance while a person is talking here. Whoever it is, please step out of this venue. Please step out of the venue, whoever it is. Please step out of the venue, whoever it is. See, please step out of the venue, whoever it is. I'll be very clear. We'll stop or else. Whoever it is, please step out of the venue. Whoever it is goes out of the venue, after that we continue. No. Whoever it is goes out. See, while the candidate is creating, it's one off sound that's coming. This started at 8 o'clock. Mess starts at 6:45. No, that is your priority. That is you sorting. This started at 8 o'clock, 7:45. Mess starts at 6:45. There was clear mess timings. No, that is not a reason. Whoever it is, please step out of the venue. She feels she has already answered that question in whatever she has said earlier.
So that is not much more clear.
No repetition. If you don't have any new thing. No, it's first question to Rohan, Shrinath.
So Rohan, you had mentioned that you will be putting ropes in Manohar Shivasa Stadium, right?
No, it is in Camp Plus, Cricket Camp Plus, because ropes are required for boundary recognition in cricket.
Cricket ground, yeah. So
hold your mic closer.
Yeah. So you had mentioned that you will be putting the rope around Sanmar ground, right? So do you know why they don't put it over there? Do you know the reason why they don't put it over there? The ropes.
They have white chalk system. They do they paint the boundaries. No,
I'm
but
asking why don't they put ropes?
Because I think they don't came with this idea. So I came with this idea.
Guys,
okay, Rohan, so even if you want to put the ropes, do we know who is the in charge for Sanmar Ground?
This is an initiative, and I think when it will be implemented, then we automatically it will be come into act.
So, in charge for Sanmar Ground is Ajay, and they don't put ropes over there because when fielders go near the boundary, they might tangle and fall down. It's for the safety reasons.
Thank you for the information.
So my next question goes to Keerthana. Keerthana, do you know that there is sports calendar already there with SOC, Sports Organizing Committee? And there is a reason why they don't put it out. We can't fix on a proper calendar at the start of the semester. Did you know that? And how do you plan on doing that?
To answer your questions, for the first part of your questions, yes, I do know that the sports calendar exists with the SOC. I am a part of the SOC and I was the captain 2 years ago, so I was a part of making that calendar for 2 years. And to answer the question about why that is not made accessible to everybody, my sports calendar is going to be a dynamic calendar. So at the beginning of the semester, when we upload it on when we integrate it with the IITM students app, and when we upload it on the IITM website, slots will be filled. So you know that these days there will be, say, tennis shorter or say cricket shorter, but the matches, whether it is Ganga versus Jamuna or Alaknanda versus Godavari, that will be decided as the semester progresses. So at least you will have a indication of when shorter or when any other competitive event rather is, and so you can plan your commitments that way.
Did you know that the SOC calendar which is already there does the same thing which you are proposing? What is the new thing which you are bringing in? It's a sports secretary's responsibility to actually tell people that what's happening when. It's not a manifesto point.
My sports calendar is, again, yes, giving information to people, but it will be, this sports calendar will be published at the beginning of the semester. So at the beginning of the semester itself, you have an idea of how the semester is going to pan out to be. Yes, SOC already has it. SOC does this exactly the same, but sports, like knowledge about sports and information about sporting events, is something that every student in the institute should know. And every student in the institute, I think, needs to know at the beginning
of the
semester.
Stick to the answer.
Accessibility. Access to information here is key. And that is what I am trying to achieve here. Better access to information of sporting events of clubs and events. Santi.
Did you hear what I said? It's a responsibility of sports secretary to let everyone know what's happening when. It's not a manifesto point. It's not a new initiative.
if you want to break every manifesto point down to why it is being done, yes, it boils down to it being the responsibility of the Institute Sports Secretary. But what new is being done here is improving accessibility of information. So I think that answers your question about why it is a manifesto point. Rohan, how do you plan on maintaining and creating a complaints portal, and how will you go about addressing these complaints?
Managing the things, means how, for example, inter-hostel competitions are going on. So I would make a proper orientation and putting online and providing it in S-mail and giving more information.
Let me break this down for you. Who are the stakeholders that are going to create this complaints portal, and how are you going to bucket these complaints, and which teams or who rather is going to address these complaints?
First of all, I will talk to the captains who are conducting the events. And according to that, I will plan. Means, what are the things?
So, do you think that the role of the institute team captain is to address the complaints of the student body?
No. For complaint, there would be independent complaint panel, independent of the captains, and that will directly go to the sports secretary.
What is it?
He said that there will be an independent complaints panel.
No. What is it that you want to display?
I want to display a chart.
Okay.
So that is with regard to the to some of the initiatives that Shrinath has proposed in his manifesto.
Where is this chart from?
It's a table of the budget that I have calculated.
Okay. You first ask the question and then we'll see if the...
All right. So... this is based on rough calculations that I've done regarding some of the initiatives that you have proposed. So for splitting NSO program into batches, the total budget for your coach comes out to be around 8.5 lakhs. The budget required for non-marking shoes is again coming out to be 96,000. The budget required for weekly refreshments is now 79,000. And the dietitian sessions itself cost 25,000. So roughly, when you add all of this up, you get around 10 lakhs. So where do you plan on sourcing this 10 lakhs from? And how are you going to go about doing it?
Okay, Keerthana, so I'll ask you one question instead. Where does NSO coaches' fees come from?
Shrinath, you can answer it. It's her round to question you.
Fine. So I can give you my budget over here. If you want my budget, you can go through it. Yeah. So, I couldn't hear
the
you
question
properly.
Was
can you
very
tell all the budget?
Srinath, the question was, where is the source of all this? If you have some other figures, please present it quick.
Yeah. So, what were your figures?
So, you have a bunch of initiatives.
Just the total.
What were your figures?
Again? Yeah. The dietitian sessions cost 25,000. The budget required for weekly refreshments is 79,000. For non-marking shoes is around 96,000.
What is your total, Keerthana?
My total is coming out to be 10 lakhs.
Srinath, your total.
So, Keerthana, I'll tell you that I was finance core for sports organizing committee. And if you want to... And if you want to see my budget, you can have a look. I've already shown this to sports advisor and he has agreed on this. So do you have any problem with that?
My question is
Srinath,
the budget over here. Do you want to see?
Shrinath, the question was, is your total any different from what she has said?
Whatever you have mentioned, there is a slight variation, but you missed out on gym equipments which will be bought by Kishore. And that 24 lakhs will be saved, and I'll be using that to put whatever new initiatives which I am bringing in. So, and let me tell you, the budget, my budget is less than what Kishore is proposing.
So basically this 24 lakhs is the one-time investment that Kishore has done in order to get the gym equipment ready, right? So as far as my understanding goes, the sports budget of 18-19 budgeted these to be around 18 lakhs. So there is an there seems to be an inconsistency there.
I think Kishore had given you the work to get the Ilanco set of weightlifting team. You missed out on that. So that again will be bought. And the total is 24 lakhs totally.
Done. So with that, cross-questioning comes to an end. We have 20 minutes left in our timing. So decide accordingly. How many GSB questions? Just a show of hands. Okay, first executive council and then we'll go there. Be quick and also be quick in your answers. Do not explain whatever you have already explained during either cross-questioning or your presentation, or if it's there in your feasibility report.
So hi guys. So my first question would be to Rohan Lal. Bro, I respect what you're doing right now actually. So I just need to know, why are you contesting for the sports secretary post and not any other post?
Rohan, wait. Will your manifesto answer this question? Have you written in your manifesto why you're contesting?
We just need to know why he's contesting for the post.
This will give me experience and to improve myself. Also, it would increase my leadership qualities.
Okay, next. So this question goes to each one of you. So as we know that Inter-IIT is going to happen in two places from next year, so whom will you appoint as IIT Madras representative for the other place?
So from the contingent, me and Keerthana were the only persons to actually come up. And that's why I think if I am going to Kharagpur, Keerthana should be the representative for the other IIT.
What if both are you in Kharagpur?
So, I did not get you, sorry.
What will you do if both your sport happens in the same location?
So right now there will be a board meeting and they will be deciding on the sports later on. So after that is done, then only we can
what
decide.
What is your solution to it if both of your sport is at the same place?
We'll be having a discussion when this board meeting happens. Depending on what sports are there in the other IIT, we'll be deciding on which captain to be representing as the representative for board meeting, which will happen in that IIT.
My answer partly remains the same. My answer partly remains the same. If Shrinath and I are in different contingents, we will be going ahead with it. But if we were to be in the same place, then the senior most captain or one of the PG representatives or the women's representative will handle the other contingent. I feel that they are well equipped. I feel they are well equipped to do so.
Rohan.
Can you repeat the question?
Bro, so next year, Inter-IIT is going to happen at two places.
Please loud.
Okay, it's okay. Chill. Pack. So, question to Shrinath. Could you elaborate on the elective course which you are going to implement?
See, in your manifesto, you have mentioned that you are going to take up an elective course. Can you tell me what is the procedure to get a course into the institute? Like, how do you formulate a course and how does it come to the curriculum?
So, let me tell you, we can have two ways. What I'll be following is, I'll be attaching an SOP and passing it through SLC. After that, Dean has already agreed on this 3 credits course,
Dean
of students.
Wait.
There will be BCA.
Who is Dean of students to approve the course? What is the procedure?
Let me complete.
I am.
Yeah.
What is the procedure for getting any course into the institute? Not only your course, any random course into the institute. How do you get in?
It should be passed through BCA and then through Senate meeting. So
what is BCA?
Board of BCA is board of. I'm not sure of the full form, but BCA is the one which we will be proposing it to.
What is
the council of faculties?
Who will propose to BCA? Whatever
Dean
is your
has
BCA,
agreed,
will propose to BCA.
Dean has agreed on proposing it in BCA.
BAC is, it is called BAC,
BAC
Board of
yeah.
Academic Courses.
Academic
and
Courses.
Who proposes to BAC?
Dean has agreed on proposing
Which
it
Dean?
In Dean of Students.
Okay.
Yeah.
Dean has agreed to propose it to BAC.
In BAC.
So Dean will be the faculty advisor. So if you are, who is this course targeted for? I am assuming it's only for inter-IIT players, right? Then why can't it be a workshop and why does it have to be a course?
See, I'll be having this 80% for inter-IIT contingent and I'll open up for 20% for other people too.
If you open up, how will you allot? How will you allot the course to other to
all the
students?
The 20% is through SEAT, SEAT, and remaining 80%.
Do you know that can GN courses, I am assuming because Dean is proposing this course, it's going to be a GN course.
Yeah.
Can that be under SEAT? What is the full form of SEAT? And can that be under SEAT?
How many follow-ups are there? I understand that you know a lot about courses and all.
Rahul.
No need to answer what is SEAT. Can you tell me, can GN courses be offered under SEAT?
See.
See, if Dean of Students has agreed on working on this, then what is your problem? I don't understand.
See, Dean of Courses does not.
I also considered Dean Academic Courses and Dean of Students. Both have agreed on this.
Who is Dean of Students to agree? Dean Academic Courses.
I have talked to both of them regarding this.
What is talking, Ra? Talking doesn't do anything. In your feasibility report, when you are introducing a course, there needs to be a curriculum. And what are the credits? And is it going to be a free elective? How is it going to be allotted? Then why don't you do it?
It will be a 3 credits course. It'll be a 3 credits course.
I am just saying it can be a workshop. It need not be a course. That's it. Done. 20% can be course, right? 20% of students can come through a workshop as well. Why does it need to be a course? That's it.
So, you're just asking why does it need to be a course, right? But it is possible to bring in a course, right? What you said was, it is possible to bring in a course, right? You yourself are saying that it's possible.
Rahul.
You yourself are now saying it is possible.
Dude, it is possible. It is possible, but so you don't know how. But you don't know how, and your feasibility doesn't add up. That's all I'm saying. And it's not required.
Okay.
And it's not required.
So, I talked to dean students and dean academic courses.
Srinath, you're repeating. Srinath, stop.
Yeah.
See, what the academic affairs secretary says is that the groundwork you have done for this, according to him, is not enough to propose a course. And he also feels that the course is not required, but it is possible.
Yeah. The basic requirement for this course was, if you have played Inter-IT, you know that we lost in Inter-IT
no.
because we couldn't handle the game pressure.
See, but you can't say it is not required.
Next question.
So, question to Keerthana. So, honestly speaking, your manifesto does not actually help with the sporting culture of the institute. More than improving the sporting culture itself, you have focused on improving just the image. It's like, it looks like a PR stunt. So, my question
no,
to
no.
you is that...
What was that comment?
No, it's just a comment.
What is...
So, basically, she's not concentrating on the sporting culture of the institute. Instead, she's just improving the image. It looks like that. So... Yeah. So my question to you is that, what are you going to celebrate without winning anything?
What are you going to celebrate?
Without winning anything. What
in
are you
what
going
context?
To do about it?
In what context?
Inter-IT. Like any sport.
Clarification on not winning anything. What? Who does that?
So.
Who does that add up to? So
what
are you
saying? Going to do to improve one's performance? So only if there is enough performance and if we win it, we can celebrate it, right?
Right. So are you suggesting that we have a dearth of sporting heritage to celebrate?
No. I'm not suggesting anything here. I'm just asking you, what are you going to do to improve one's performance?
All right. So a major part of why each player, a major part of why every student athlete plays a sport every day is because he or she loves that sport. He or she
just
is inspired.
Present, answer to me.
He or she is inspired to play that sport by someone that he or she looks up to. So inspiration is key to increasing performance of anybody, and not just improving the team's performance. It is also important to include more people in the sporting culture.
Just answer to my question.
I have
what?
Answered.
No. You're not saying what are you going to do to improve one's performance. Just answer to that.
All right. So if you are asking me to answer it only in the context of my celebrate initiatives, I have answered it. But regarding the rest of my manifesto, there are several other initiatives that address this issue. Visual footage is one. Visual footage of important matches and practice drills can vastly improve teams' performance and individual skill sets. And including more people in the system and creating a talent pool rather by using active player groups is also another way to improve our overall performance.
So they're in the manifesto.
See, inclusion doesn't, like, you can't improve the performance by including more people into sport.
Why not? A lot of the captains said that they lack bench strength, that they have 16 people coming to practice every day and 16 people getting into the team. Why is including
sport?
More basketball? If I were to take names.
Which basketball team? Men or women?
Men.
Men.
Both the captains stated this during the captains' meetings that they didn't have enough bench strength and that
they didn't say bench strength. So it means that the performance of the bench, they're not strong enough.
I'm not paraphrasing at all. This is exactly what the captains had said. They said that they didn't even...
See.
See,
you're like it's a wordplay basically. No, bench strength as in there it's are not people a word to play, right. But they are not.
Okay. I believe that the team performance of Inter IIT will improve if we include more people in the system and nurture them to grow and facilitate channels to improve their performance. So once we get that system going, the team performance will definitely increase.
Sorry, you're not answering to my question. So I'll just move on to the next question.
Do you have any other executive meanwhile?
And I just want to clarify on this women's gym. So the dean or the advisor, actually they said they'll just look into it. But when I asked them, they said they won't be, I mean, we don't have budget for it. So it's not possible.
Again, we seem to be...
They are ready to reallocate the gym somewhere else and have an instructor or... You have to get the consent from the Sabarmati hostel inmates.
May I ask when you spoke to the dean?
The day before yesterday.
I spoke to dean of students today morning also.
They are, see, do you know hostel comes under CCW purview?
Yes.
So we can't do anything about it like...
Exactly, but we already have infrastructure facilities in hostel zone 2 that come under the institute's purview. And because this is a necessity...
Right now... We are not able to manage it. That's the more reason they don't want to involve in this.
Exactly. But the necessity here far exceeds that.
See, it's not possible. That's what I'm saying.
What is the question there?
So what she said was, she'll bring up a women's instructor in Sabarmati Hostel Gym. First of all, they are not ready to do it because it comes under CCW and not under Gymkhana.
I have clarified this earlier. I said that it is.
So... What is it's not
her,
possible.
Her answer to this would be?
I'm not disagreeing the fact that it comes under CCW and I'm not disagreeing the fact that the fees of that should come from the hostel sports budget. But when necessity arises, when there are lots of girls wanting to go to the gym and when the necessity is there, dean, students and sports advisor have reconsidered it. They want to imply...
See, her answer is dean, students and sports advisor have reconsidered it and they have agreed to it.
So they haven't and they didn't agree. That's all. That's my stand.
No, Shrinath, my question is to you. You have spoken about the grievance management system, right? So could you explain how you're going to implement this grievance management system? And just a follow-up on that, you have said that you'll introduce a WebOps team under SOC. So as a co-curricular secretary, I know how difficult it is to find people who will do WebOps in C5 and Shastra. So first of all, how will you implement the grievance system? And what about a WebOps strength? Where will you find those squads? Or are you looking at collab?
So I already have the team ready. And these people are into towards sports. And that's how I could get them. And I have minimal work which needs to be done because the website is already made by the Institute WebOps team. And now we'll be introducing only this grievance management portal and few other changes like PG part-time job, all that tabs will be there. So there is minimal number of changes and this can be done.
Hi Shrinath, I just have a clarification. By always saying that I have a team ready, are you fostering nepotism? By saying that I have a team ready even before you get elected, are you fostering nepotism?
When I said I have a team ready, I have a set of people who will be writing this application and I'll be selecting them based on their talent.
Second question.
Alright, my question is to Keerthana. So there is a point about you branding sports merchandise into iCollege. Can I know what groundwork you have done on this, the people who you have talked to?
The Chairman Council of Wardens and the Chief Financial Officer.
Do you know who executes all the portal infrastructure things in iCollege?
Tristan.
Have you talked to somebody from Tristan?
I haven't, but I know that we have to pay a nominal fee of 15,000 to 20,000 rupees.
How much is the fee that you are thinking of?
15,000 to 20,000 is what?
15,000 is the maintenance fee. For building the infrastructure, you'll have to pay an addition of 30,000. So your total sum here is 45,000. Now, where are you going to get that fund from?
I feel that it is a nominal fee when compared to the sales that I'm expecting from the iCollege website. To give parallel comparisons, Shastra was selling merchandise, and it saw an increase of about 4 lakh sales when they introduced it on iCollege. Similar statistics was followed in Sarang as well. When Sarang was not on iCollege and when Sarang was on iCollege, there was an increase in sales to about 5 to 6 lakhs. So I think this boom in sales will accommodate for that, and it is a nominal fee, in fact.
All right, Shastra Sarang figures aside, what is the ballpark figure you are expecting for through your sports merchandise, the sales amount, ballpark figure?
I do not have a ballpark figure as of now.
Because you'll always be eating into Shastra Sarang, I mean.
I mean, Keerthana, as a co-cast and as a Kulsec, we are concerned that are you going to increase the cap which the students can pay for iCollege sales?
No.
That means that you're going to eat into my sales, right?
That's right. So, but I see.
Let me just complete. So, for me, it's only t-shirt sales. For cultural secretaries, it's also ticket sales. So, are you going to affect the amount of people who attend Sarang Pro Shows? And the sales that we have been generating for so long.
I feel that the student community should be given the opportunity rather to select between merchandise or Sarang Shastra and sports. If they have the opportunity to buy sports, like they should be facilitated for the same. And the decision lies with the students. It is their choice ultimately whether they want to choose between Shastra and Sarang and Institute Sports Merchandise. And if they want to buy Institute Sports Merchandise, they should be facilitated to do so. And if they don't have enough money in the iCollege deposit, nobody is stopping them from adding money to that iCollege deposit and buying all three. So my intention here... My intention here is to not compete with Sarang and Shastra, but rather expand the opportunities that these students have in their hands.
Do you have the statistics on the number of people adding money to iCollege and buying merchandise for Shastra and Sarang?
They have never been given the opportunity to buy for Institute Sports Merchandise.
Do you have the data? No. Okay, so on what grounds are you saying that they'll obviously add money and buy merchandise?
How does that stop me from putting Institute merchandise on iCollege?
I have a follow-up. So if you know PG students don't pay that extra cap for iCollege, how are you going to sell this merchandise to PG students?
So we will again follow what the fests are doing. We will have a sales on Finders website also. We will have it on our sports website as well.
The problem in selling outside iCollege is that there is an additional service charge a PG student should pay. So why should a PG student pay that service charge extra when IU students are not paying in iCollege?
Again, it is the decision of the PG students to not have paid for that iCollege deposit. If he or she chooses to not pay for that iCollege deposit and want to buy student, I'm not forcing anybody to buy Institute
PG
merchandise.
PG students cannot pay iCollege deposit.
Yes.
It is not their option whether to pay or not. They cannot pay iCollege deposit.
Right. Again, I'm not forcing anybody to buy Institute Sports merchandise. It is.
I'm saying it's not possible
okay.
for...
No, it is their choice to buy it with the additional service charge, right?
Why do you want to sell the same merchandise at a different price, higher price for PG students?
We can work around discounted prices to the PG students so that the service charge and that amounts to the same thing.
Have you done any groundwork with those selling platforms on whether such a discount can be worked out?
No.
Okay. So the conclusion of your point is that you want to give the opportunity to the students to decide what they want to buy. So you do agree that it will take a hit on Shastra t-shirt sales. Because if some people decide to go for the other thing, definitely. Statistically, for it to add up, it will take a hit.
It depends on the publicity and PR teams of Shastra, Sarang and Institute Sports Merchandise.
Yeah, yeah, correct.
So, let's assume you do great publicity. Depending upon how they pitch it.
Yeah, given your manifesto, I can clearly see you're a very good...
Will it take a hit or not?
At PR, the conclusion is statistically, we'll take a hit. Yes? Cool. Thank you.
So, wait, is this Executive Council or GSP?
Okay, so I have a common question to all of the candidates. Before that, let me clarify, I don't want any rhetorical answers. I don't want you to beat around the bush. Please be very specific. What are your requirements in terms of SLC? What are the needs and requirements which a sports secretary should fulfill for SLC? A very common question to all three of you. I would request Shrinath to start.
We should propose the budget. We should attend all the SLC meeting which comes under us in our domain. And we should abide by the standing committee and we should work along with them.
Okay, anything more you want to add? Okay, Rohan. I'll make the question simpler for you. What is SLC? Can you expand SLC?
I don't know what is SLC.
Okay, so let's... Maybe we should work more and popularize SLC more.
Guys,
okay,
calm
Keerthana.
Down.
Financial accountability of all executive student bodies under SLC and information transparency with regard to any meeting that the executive student body does. This is two major things that the sports secretary needs to comply to. And also, participate in any grievance matters that comes to SLC with regard to sports.
Okay. I got to know that some of you have proposed some policies. So, will it be so that those policies can be directly taken up by faculty advisor or dean students, or those policies has to go through SLC first?
The club which I have proposed should go through SLC as it's increasing the POR and
okay.
That's a statement.
Okay. Do you have any policy proposals in your manifesto?
Yes, I do have introduction of PR, para sports representative, and rebrand. That's the only policy change as such in terms of my in terms of the executive student body.
Okay, so where does it fall? Where it comes? Will it come in constitution or rule book or charter? Where will it come?
Rule book.
Okay, thank you. And okay, we'll move on. Thank you.
Okay, Rohan, I have a question for you. This is. So, this is from your manifesto, if you have the manifesto with you. It says, I, Rohan Lal, contesting for the post of ISS, would create an atmosphere where no enthusiasm is left. I mean, guys. Was it a typo? If yes, please clarify for the voters what you wanted to convey when you said no enthusiasm is left.
Means no talent is left behind and everyone.
Left behind. Keerthana, my question is for you. You spoke about the using cameras for analyzing sports, right? So I had a point last year, if you have gone through my manifesto, that something about sports tech, where you would analyze the videos and do some analysis. Now, are you aware of the fact that you need to record those videos in certain angles and in certain ways to get proper data to analyze? Do you have the infrastructure, capital, and the expertise to implement that?
I've spoken about visual footage solely for the team's improvement and team's performance. We don't need data analytics right now to go through all of them. But we can, but just by looking at these videos, we can understand the gaps in our attack or the flaws in our defense strategies. Huh. So analysis is something that I would like to have as a long-term vision. But right now, I do not have any plans. With regard to your manifesto point, I think you wanted to calculate win
percentage. Check my manifesto. What I'm getting at is even for your analysis, just looking at it, the shooting has to be done in certain angles, right? It can't be random footage from long shot.
Yes, I do study image vision.
Do you have the money, infrastructure in place, capital in place?
So right now we are only going to purchase sports action cameras that cost around 5,000 and a decent tripod stand that costs about 800. So the entire set would cost 6,000. So I'm looking at purchasing two or three of these equipment and circulating them among all teams, depending upon who need it when.
Okay, and given the number of sports people and number of people, you think that's enough? 2-3 cameras. Okay, cool. I think 2 cameras are enough. This is in general question about your personality. Having known you, I personally feel that to be a secretary, there is some amount of leadership that you need to show. So, do you think you're equipped with that? If yes, how are you going to display that?
Sorry, can you...
This is a question about your leadership in general. Leadership. What I know about you is you're a very nice person, very soft person. Do you have the ability to display... No, my question is, do you have the personality to lead?
You can choose to answer or not choose to answer. It's your choice. You can choose to answer or not choose to answer.
As you said, that makes me more accessible to students. And that's how I feel I'll be a better leader.
Okay, one question regarding SLC. Because you have proposed many new policies, it is regarding budget. So what is the requirement, voting requirements to get a budget passed in the SLC? Is it simple majority? Is it two-third majority? Is it three-fourth majority?
As I attended the SLC meeting which was there previously, the majority needs to be half of the speakers, legislators which are there.
Legislators present and voting, present. Okay. Keerthana, is it a simple majority, two-third majority or three-fourth majority for getting a budget passed?
Six.
You know or don't know? That's okay.
I'm not aware.
Sorry?
I'm not aware.
Okay, two-third. Two-third is the requirement. Thank you.
Executive Council done. We'll move on. Core team. Okay. Core team. How many? 5 questions. We are out of time. 5 questions. Sir, how many more minutes? 5 more minutes.
This is the question from the core team. This is the question to Keerthana, the first question. In your SOC team restructuring, I've seen that you've scrapped the SOC head position. Am I right? I'm clarifying this. You scrapped the SOC head position.
No. They will be leading the teams, they will be leading sponsorship and PR.
But when you have actually taken the effort to put the course, why haven't you taken the effort to include the SOC head? First question. Okay, clarification is done. Okay, if that clarification is done, do you know how many cords are there presently in the SOC team right now?
Yes, I do.
How many?
So there are 12 coordinators in the FR team,
okay.
4 in sponsorship and PR.
Okay.
In effect, there are no coordinators in the media team. There are 2 coordinators in the design team and in the finance team, there are 4.
Okay, the design and media team, the design and
it's
media team
same.
Is the same.
Yeah.
So you have 2 coordinators.
Okay,
do you know how many people apt for all these positions? Do you have the statistics of how many people actually apt for all these positions?
No, I don't have statistics for that.
Okay. And do you know how many people left during the tenure? During the tenure?
I'm aware of that.
Including one core?
I'm aware of that.
So how do you plan on incentivizing people to stay, and given the n number of events you've actually given for the SOC team, I appreciate that your initiative of actually including rebranding SOC team, but how do you plan on actually motivating them throughout the year?
All right. First question is, aspiring coordinators meet was not conducted last year. That can be a major attribute to why we didn't get a lot of applicants. The second thing, I think the incentive for any position of responsibility comes from the responsibility that is added to that position. So if you have, if you can tell the coordinator that he or she has worked throughout the year and that they can achieve a learning curve out of that position, I think that is incentive enough for them to apply.
Point number one, clarification. All coordinators meet, if I'm right, happened in my first year. That is in Sethu's, during Sethu's
tenure. I'm talking about the academic year 18-19.
Okay, I'm giving you previous year stats, precedence. So the first one, Sethu's year, it happened. SOC team had less than 25 coordinators with an all coordinator meet. And also, do you sure. think it's not
the question?
Do you think people are not aware of their responsibilities enough right now that they don't think they have a learning curve? I don't understand. What are you implying by the fact that they do not understand the responsibilities they have right now?
I'm saying that with my initiatives in the manifesto and mapping them to each team in SOC, they have additional responsibilities that they have to handle. Responsibilities that will sustain for an entire year. Responsibilities that will sustain an entire year and not just in spikes around Sportsfest and not just in spikes around inter-IIT.
If you had actually asked everybody, I'm telling you that it cannot be done. And if you do it, I would appreciate you in your tenure.
See, I myself...
I'm done.
So this is a common question for both Shrinath and Keerthana because you're a part of the institute team. So, you know that all of the teams have been practicing very hard, and every time we go to the inter-IIT, it's always like go for 19, and it's just not happening. We think that the teams are performing really well here, but then something goes wrong there, and it just doesn't happen. So, what do you think? Because none of you have any manifesto points regarding that. What are your measures for that? How do you think? The teams can be improved, and what is the main reason for our teams not performing well there?
As I clearly mentioned, the main reason why we lost in Schroeter and in Triity was that we have talent, but we don't have the ability to handle game pressure, and that's why I'll be introducing this elective course wherein they'll be teaching how to handle game pressure. That's why I am doing. You said that there is no manifesto point which focuses on that. I'm giving a justification why I'll be bringing that change.
Okay, and Shrinath, we can bring next point. That.
And I'll be concentrating on nutrition too. I'll be having a workshop by dietitian and introducing nutrition chart in sports website. So this again was one of the main reason why we could not win GC.
Do you think just introducing the nutrition chart would really help? Do you think everybody can actually go procure whatever the nutrition that is needed? And is the institute well equipped to provide all the nutrition that's like
even optimizing on whatever food resources we have will actually make a great impact. And for first step, I'll be installing vending machines near Gymkhana and SAC with nutrition bars and energy drinks. And I'll also focus on gymming. One of the main reasons why we lost in inter-IIT was that we lacked on strength. And that's why I'll be focusing more on gymming too. Maybe
okay,
that justifies it.
Keerthana. Same question.
Yeah, I agree with the fact that mental resilience is a factor in us not winning inter-IIT general championship for a few years now. But I think that can be better addressed within the team culture. If someone from the outside comes to me and tells me on handling pressure during my situations, I don't think I'll be as receptive to him as opposed to my teammate telling me to do better during match performances or my coach doing so. So mental resilience should come from within the team, and this is something that I will be working on closely with the captains and the coaches. And about improving our inter-IIT performance as a whole, I think somewhere along the line, we forgot how privileged we are that to represent IIT Madras. Whenever most teams come and play on the court, I feel that they don't acknowledge that they are wearing an IIT Madras jersey and that they are playing for our institute. That inspiration and that drive to win inter IIT is something that is missing. That is why I have a dedicated section to celebrating our student athletes and their contributions to inter IIT.
Okay, I expect both Shrinath and Keerthana to answer this. Okay. So, you both know that the swimming pool is being closed because of water shortage in Chennai. And aquatics contributes about 30 points to inter-IIT, right? So, what are your plans for practice to not suffer?
There is Velachery pool which is there outside and Ruchir is in constant touch with them. And
okay, what has happened on that? Do you have any information on that? Also, if we cannot do that, if we cannot go to Velachery pool to practice, what are your plans to do?
I'll be introducing fitness sessions with refreshments and we can focus on more fitness when there is, it is not peak season, right? So you can focus more on fitness, thereby not having a long gap between your practice sessions.
And do you think it's really feasible?
Sorry?
Do you think it's really feasible for all of the swimmers to just go to Velachery pool and come back? Do you know how strenuous it is for us to practice 5-6 hours a day during the semester? Mainly July and August, July, August and September when the semester is open. And it's just not going to happen if we'll have to travel all day, every morning and evening for it.
See, that's the only option which is left. And as the swimming pools are closed, we'll be providing institute buses for you guys to travel over there. And that's the only possible solution for swimming practices. And we can focus on fitness when there is not...
I think that's all. Nothing more to add. Now, Keerthana.
We can look at using recycled water for the swimming pool. Recycled water when we use for the swimming pool might cause trouble in the maintenance of the swimming pool, but then they will be processed more in order to do so.
Okay, do you have details on what the water purification process is?
There is a water purification plant in IIT Madras, so we can probably
consult. Any more details on that is a question.
So, this has already been proposed and it was rejected by the engineering unit people.
Guys, for all your presentations, my question is for Keerthana. My question is for Keerthana. So you've suggested to completely scrap out the women's timing at the main gym, right? So firstly, how are you going to ensure the quality of equipments and the number of equipments in Sabarmati? Because right now, it's not even the 50% of what's in the main gym. And secondly, you do know that female students are not the only one accessing the main gym. There are also other residents and staff members who are women who access this gym. So how are you going to accommodate them in Sabarmati? Even if you do, there's obviously going to be entry issues. How are you going to tackle that? Also, in this regard, it's not just the sports advisor and the dost who's involved. It's also the warden. So have you talked to the warden? How are you going to tackle the situation?
So, with regard to scrapping the women's only timings, it is also accessible to women. Women can go there, but their exclusivity factor is reduced. If people have problems to go to the gym during a time that is not exclusive only to women, they can get special permission from the Sabarmati warden and enter the Sabarmati gym.
But then, what's the whole point of scrapping the women's timing then?
See. The point of scrapping women's timings is to make sure that the excessive crowd after 5:30 gets evenly distributed.
So, one thing I want to ensure, I go to the gym every day and there is no excessive crowd. There are not enough women going in this time period. So there is no excessive crowd at all.
Excessive crowd after 5:30, I mean. Mm-hmm. After 5:30, the gym is pretty crowded. So I want to thin out that crowd and open the gym to everyone from 5:30.
Have you asked the warden about this? The Sabarmati warden?
Keerthana, the point is, does this mean that girls who are uncomfortable using the common timing will not have access to proper quality of gym?
Those that are not the residents of IIT Madras, yes, they can take special permission from Sabarmati warden and can enter the...
I think there was one more question regarding whether you have spoken to the warden.
No, there are very few people.
Keerthana, did you talk to the warden? Did you talk to the warden?
Like Shrinath mentioned, we have non-inter-IT clubs as well. We will have club flagship events for all clubs that will also happen for the sports that are not in inter-IIT. As well as non-competitive sports league, that is something that I want to do for foosball, snooker and frisbee. See, so that will also happen.
We'll be having sports days of the week wherein these non-inter-IIT clubs will have beginner sessions and club weekenders.
Okay,
this is open for everyone so that
I have. I have mentioned in my feasibility that there would be an open chess competition. We have rapid, but instead of rapid, we would have a time limits of 30.
Does chess come much under non-interactive? Okay, you. So, do you know we have chess championship, right? I am asking about non-inter-IIT.
Yeah, that is non-inter-IIT, chess blitz.
Thank you.
So, Shrinath, you mentioned about the Velachery Pool point. You said that Ruchir is constantly in contact with Velachery Pool. So, I just talked with Ruchir. He said he's not in contact whatsoever. Besides that, my question to Shrinath and Keerthana, as you know, some certain institute teams have decided not to participate in Schroiter. And the sports secretary has urged other teams to also consider this. What is your opinion regarding this?
To me, Schroiter is a competitive event. A competitive event where the sports talent in the institute can shine. So if I were to answer it crisply, I will definitely want the institute team players to play for Schroiter. We can enhance participation of students as such through other avenues, but primarily Schroiter is a competition.
Okay.
So what I feel is Schroiter should be given, we should be giving opportunity for other students who are not in inter-IIT, and hence I, as an athletics captain, I told my teams.
You're the athletics captain?
Yeah. So I had suggested this to my team too, and they agreed on giving opportunity to other students who are not in inter-IIT.
Please, GSB questions. Here. No, I'm already taking a question here.
My question is to Keerthana. You have mentioned that you will introduce chess in Schroiter. I have already proposed this to both Dhyanesh and Kishore. Both this year and last year. Both of them said it's not possible. Do you know what's the issue surrounding this and how do you propose to solve it? Because for me, it looks like an empty promise.
All right, so firstly, okay, so if we are to introduce any sport in Schroiter, we need to get it past the inter-hostel board. In light to the addition of chess in the inter-IIT main meet, I think it is time that we start honing.
Keerthana.
Chess
is not part of inter-IIT.
But I was told by the Dean of Students that in the last Dean's Council.
They just discussed it and the discussion will happen in the coming board meeting. So it's not yet decided. I am a part of the board and not Dean of Students. And also, it's an unsaid rule that only inter-IIT sports can be included in Schroiter and not any other sport.
What rule?
Only inter-IIT sport can be included in Schroiter.
That rule is not mentioned anywhere in the sports rule book.
It's an unsaid rule. That's what I started with. Unsaid rule.
Unsaid rule for what? And moreover, chess, from what Dean has told me, chess is already in the inter-IIT chess forum. It has already been announced that it is a part of next inter-IIT in Kharagpur
and
Bhubaneswar.
No, it's wrong information. I am part of the sports board and not the Dean of Students.
Okay. No, next question from this side. I have a question for Shrinath. So you said about your NSO. I have a question for Kishore also, but can I ask him that? Okay, so coming to Shrinath, about your NSO segregation. So I have 3 points to bring up. The first thing is the cap thing that you said about having, like example for football, 30 was the cap that you said. And the sports advisor said you can't have more than that. But suddenly you want to increase 2 batches and do 25 and 25 make it 50. And you said that even I agree to the point that on a daily basis the cap won't increase, but on one day you are having a combined session when there will be 50 people. Okay, that is one. Now the second issue being the coaches. Now the coaches first of all have to take intra-ID practice sessions and they also have to take NSO. For some sport like tennis where we have one coach, just need a clarification, wasn't this already covered by Keerthana? No. Okay, so NSO batches segregation again. So there's a cap that you said was 30, right? But now you are increasing the cap by having 2 batches. So, but you just said that you spoke to the sports advisor, etc., and they can't do that, right? So what about that? That is just one point. The second is the venue. For tennis courts, we require, just 1 second. It's the same question. Like it's part of the same question. So the 30 people require at least 2 courts. Yeah. So if they have 2 courts, then instant practice session happens in 2 courts. So for 3 days of the week in the odd semester, you're taking out practice, you're not letting any other person play.
Okay, I got your question.
Yeah.
So it is very sports specific, and why don't we have, I'll just put it this way. Yeah. Every time a captain discusses with the coach and decides on the cap for NSO,
yeah,
right? The maximum limit is restricted. That's why for tennis, you will be discussing with your coach on what the cap is. I have not mentioned particularly what the tennis cap will be.
Okay.
In the batch-wise system.
No, but 1 second. The point is to increase the cap, right? He's not getting the point of the question.
See, my basic motto for bringing this system was to dilute the number of students getting into NSO. So I have not mentioned that the number of students getting in tennis team, I've never mentioned the exact count there. It will always be discussed with the tennis captain and coach. See, in the start.
Shrinath. So what he's trying to say that it will hinder the intra-IIT practice. So basically right now you're going to take 3 days, right? Yeah. So
and our coach and 5 days in the even semester.
Yeah.
So there will be a combined session which will not be affecting the intra-IIT practice. There will be the combined session where it won't affect intra-IIT practice. It will happen on Saturday morning. Saturday morning.
Will freshies be ready to come on a Saturday morning?
See, there is NCC on Saturday morning, right?
Hello. One second, guys. Please. In many IITs and NITs, see, I don't know all this stuff, so just listen. Hey, please. Kokko and Kabaddi are the most important games. Whoever conducts Kokko and Kabaddi, I will support them because I am a Kokko state player. I like Kokko.
Hello, bro.
Keerthana.
Hello. Okay. Keerthana. So Keerthana, I have a question for you. So you did mention that you would ideally want institute players to play in Schreuter, right? Take the case of the women's Schreuter, wherein most of your insti players are coming from Sharavati, and you take Sabarmati, where they invariably go with a bunch of foreign exchange students. Put it against Tunga, who don't have any players in the insti team compared to Ushara, and Sarayu, who's mainly made up of NSO. How are you maintaining that you need sportiveness more than inclusivity here?
There has been a history of freshie teams beating these very institute team members in Sharavati. There has been a history of foreign exchange students beating institute teams in Sharavati. So I don't see a reason why institute players being concentrated in one hostel during this academic year and probably for the next three academic years should stop us from not passing a rule that restricts their participation.
Are we missing out on Tunga and the Indian players in Sabarmati because of this?
See, I will go back to what Schreuter is. To me, Schreuter is a competition that we participate for our, that we represent our hostel in. Something that we bring laurels to our hostel too, right? So if you want to increase participation of girls from Sarayu, Tunga and Sabarmati, we have other avenues to do so. Schreuter's standard should not be compromised. And in no way am I decreasing accessibility of sports to the rest of the girls, because we have other channels that cater to this.
Keerthana, my question is for you. Yeah. So, as a Sharavati sports secretary, I was looking into your previous manifesto when I was creating my manifesto. And looking at it now, I realized that you hadn't done quite a few of the things, like updating the Facebook page with the player profiles. And you didn't screen major sporting events. Like, if you weren't able to do all that for the hostel sports secretary, how do you think you'll be able to do that for the institute sports secretary?
Let me start by telling you the initiatives that I have done. Okay, so Sharavati Sports Corner and Sharavati Wall of Fame is something that I promised and did. Increasing freshie participation is something that I promised and is something that I have done. In fact, the number of unique participants, the tenure before me was 63, and during my tenure it was 118. So that is something that I have done. Transparency of information was something that was facilitated using Sharavati Sports Corner and a common WhatsApp group for the entire Sharavati contingent. Refreshments, although you have done one better and have given juice coupons, I gave glucose and bananas during Schreuter and Dean's Trophy. So this is something that... So if we are talking about...
So I'm asking about the points which you haven't done, and it's more than 60% of your manifesto. Like,
I disagree with that number.
See,
that it is
because
around
60. I have made a note of your manifesto and the points you haven't done.
Sure, we can discuss on that.
What is this? As your previous sports secretary of Sharav, I have also been involved in reviewing your manifesto, and I have 8 points here that you haven't done, which is most of that which you've included in your celebrate section of your manifesto. Updating Facebook page, player profiles of hostel teams, Wall of Fame wasn't updated, medicines balls weren't purchased, screening of major sporting events weren't done, no sports night or quiz nights were done, so no ice breaking session was done, videos of games weren't put up. So this is 60% of your manifesto, so the numbers are sort of tallying. Just saying that I was in the process of reviewing your manifesto.
I agree that there are some of the manifesto points that I wasn't able to do during my tenure. My tenure as a Sharaf sports secretary has given me the experience on how to go about doing these things. And I think right now I'm better equipped to aim for these things and get to do and getting them into action.
Don't you think something like creating a Facebook page for PRs?
So we already have a Sharavati hostel Facebook page in which sports updates was done. Sports updates was done on Sharavati Facebook page, but a separate page was not done.
See, this question is prolonging. We'll stop this question here right now. We'll take one question from here.
So, one common question to all of you from D5E. How effective are club weekenders in getting rank beginners? And do you think, what are your plans for B teams? Okay, and how effective are club weekenders? Do you think it's better to refocus your energy from beginners to B teams?
That's why I introduced sports days of the week, wherein we'll be having these only on Tuesdays and Fridays, so that people are aware that these club weekenders are happening on that time, and they won't miss out on things.
My active player groups consists of institute team probables, which is majorly the institute team B teams. So I have initiatives that address them apart from club weekenders, which address beginners.
Completed, right? I'm asking for like all three of you guys. So the thing is, see, in our IIT students, many of the students have like much talent. People are not recognizing them. I hope like out of you three guys, like people whoever elect for sports sec, they'll recognize their talent and they'll push them to intra-IIT. And all the best to all of the guys. Please try to like make sure it happens that Coco and Kabaddi. And please, one second. Please, I need answer from three of you guys. Please.
Hello, bro. I have mentioned. Hello.
See.
Hello.
1 minute. Hello.
I have mentioned Kabaddi and Khoko in my manifesto.
Okay. Question was regarding Kabaddi and Khoko. Kabaddi and Khoko.
Khoko is already a part of women's shoiter. I plan on having traditional sports league in which Khoko will be one of the sports, a traditional sports league with sabhas and samitis. And like Shrinath mentioned earlier, Kabaddi is a contact sport and that is not something that we can have in the institute as of now. But Khoko is something that is very doable and I have addressed that in my manifesto as well.
Okay, so
I already mentioned that Kabaddi is not allowed in the institute as it's a contact sport, and Khoko that is already Khoko happening in the institute, so you can definitely try it out.
See, we are stopping.
One last doubt, please let me clarify with Keerthana. Keerthana, you mentioned your team structure. It's just a doubt. Suppose you win, would you want a woman representative or men representative?
See, the role of a women's representative does not change with the gender of institute sports secretary. As the sports secretary...
But woman representative itself, a gender-based role, right?
It is a gender-based role, and that will a women's representative will cater to the women's contingent's needs and to the women in the institute, irrespective of whether or not the institute sports secretary is a man or a woman. As the institute sports secretary, if at all I do get elected, I will be elected by all 9,000 of you guys, right? So I will be a voice of all these 9,000 students.
You know the reason why women's representative is there? Do you know the reason why women's representative is there?
So as he was saying, the reason why we had that post for a woman, not for a person who is male, right? What was the reason?
See, no, we are done with the soapbox.
Okay, thank you.
Can anyone answer the question?
So primarily, like I said, the women's representative rules, as mentioned in the rule book, is to cater to the women's contingent, is to conduct women's shoiter and all women-related sporting events in the institute. Again, when men have been representing us for so long and they've been able to represent a minority of us, I don't see why I cannot represent the majority of you people, majority of men.
See, Keerthana, the thing is, women representative idea was when there was no representation from women's side into the team. Now, when a woman herself is a secretary, do we want a male person to represent
or not? We still need...
He means
we would still need.
So with that we have come to the. With that we have. Guys, 1 minute. With that we have come to the end of the sports secretary soapbox. We have 3 candidates. Give me a minute more, please. Keerthana, Rohan, Lal and Shrinath Bhat.